So I've been testing a lot of AI text to video tools over the last couple of months. I've tried a couple. This one, did.com. I'm going to show you an example of that and some of the issues I have with that. Synthesia, got some basic issues with this one. It's a really good product, but they actually censor religious speech or things they deem as political. So it's sort of a censored platform. Professional AI voiceover here, Synthesys.io. Pretty good, low cost, but it's just something's lacking. So what I've been working on is this platform here now, DID, to try it. It does leave a watermark. And what I'm going to do is show you how to remove that market with a tool that I have. So this is a generation. I'm going to just show you this one real quick. This is an example of something I put together this morning. I do these Bible videos every Sunday. This is a Matthew 6, 7 through 15. That is an AI person. He's a real actor, but they've AI-ified him. And that is a AI voice, which the voices are probably the most telling problem for me. Let's have a look real quick.
Bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debts.
So this is entirely generated text to video using the platform DID.com. Okay, I'm going to show you how to create a video in DID. And we've already created one. That's one I showed you earlier. I'm not going to actually create one. I'm going to go ahead and go to the create video tab. And the actor, these are HQ, high quality images. This is the fella I chose. Now I'm going to go ahead and do a green screen because I chroma key him in that video. That's where you saw the desert behind him. So that's how I did that. I pasted Matthew 5, 7 through 15 here. This is our Father. And that's what we're working with. So then I go to create video, and I'm going to hopefully this will come for you here. Generate the video. It outputs the video. Now, one of the things they have here, they have an ethics program that they will mark right here where my cursor is next to this fellow's elbow. They will mark the words AI. I'm going to remove that watermark, but I'm also going to show you what that looks like. And then I'm going to run it through a product by Wondershare to remove the watermark. So the product I'm going to show you that's going to allow this watermark removal is the Wondershare converter. It's called Unit Converter. And we're going to use the function called remove watermark. So it's remove the watermark. Now I have something off screen that I'm going to pull over. Let's go ahead and pull this over. This is the one with the AI mark in it.
And when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think.
If I can get this guy on right here. There you go. So that's what I'm going to remove. And I'm going to click over here. Notice let me just show you here. I've shown the watermark. There's the watermark. And we're just going to go ahead and click over here, remove watermark, and let's watch the magic unfold. Okay, so here's a short story. I had to do media player and VLC together. Notice on the original, this is the one before I removed the watermark. You'll see the watermark. Let me make sure you get it. It's over there so you can see it. There you go. The AI watermark is there. Here, there is no AI watermark. You cannot see any evidence of its existence whatsoever. So it did clear it out. So the difference really between Synthesia, which I really liked, and this, the AI watermark is their ethics of choice. The ethics of choice for Synthesia is to not allow their avatars to push speech forward that they feel could be offensive. And again, when a platform determines that, it's their right, it's their platform, they can do whatever they want. If they don't want you talking about tacos, you can't talk about tacos, but it's limiting in what you can do. However, in their defense, mildly, you can do yourself and put yourself out there as an avatar as well. Synthesia will allow that, but more time, more money, more effort. And the whole point of these AI tools is to reduce friction and effort. So that would be an additional time and expense. And there's a lot of things that I've seen on the internet, how involved it is to actually get the right situation to put an avatar of yourself up. That's the only way you get this forward. I'll show you something else that I had from Synthesia, their terms of service and what I experienced with them when I was trying to do some things around Christmas. So what you see here is basically the content moderation rejection from Synthesia. They sent me the note, your video contains religious content, and to do this, you're required to have a custom avatar, even if the video doesn't infringe on other people's rights. Now, that wasn't always consistent. The Quran, the Bible, they definitely blocked those out. This is me doing a For God So Loved the World sort of thing. They killed this one, and you'll see the rejected side in a minute. They did not reject LGBTQ or other things, which actually are also in accord with their terms of service.
Oh.